someone selling cookies? What?
Whoa, who's that? Where is he? I can see him on here.
Hi there, everyone.
Welcome back to the channel.
I hope you guys like that short little intro. If you're new here, my name is Kenny. And how are you guys doing today? I'm doing fine. As you can see, I'm still alive, still kicking. My family's doing well. Everyone has been doing great. Not catching the virus, knock on wood. But yes, we're doing fine. I hope you guys are fine too. And right now, I want to take a moment out to thank each and every one of you guys that have liked my videos. And also for those who have subscribed to the channel. The channel has now grew over the 1,000 subscriber mark. And I could not have done it without you guys. Thank you so much for your love, your support. And thank you so much for sharing my videos and getting it out there so other people can enjoy it. So now I'm going to be giving away 2 free gifts. First gift that I'm going to be giving away is this 360 degrees camera system. Let me just say that I'm not in any way sponsored by the company or anything like that. This is my own money that I'm going to be spending to give away to you guys as a thank you for supporting the channel. And for the second prize, it's going to be on a free wireless alarm system for your vehicle. It's a GSM, so it does the calling and the texting to let you know the status if any alarm has gone off or if anything is going on. And if you haven't seen that already, check out the link up above. So stay tuned until the next videos for more details on how you can win the prizes. But now let's just dive into this camera system reviews and tutorial. Now for the feature of the system, all of the cameras have wide-angle lenses, so now you'll be able to see more around your vehicle. 2, the system is very easy to install and easy to set up, as I'll demonstrate that to you in a little bit here. Number 3, parallel parking. You all know with a big fan, it's going to be really hard for you to see when you parallel park, and it's really hard for you to watch the curve. Not anymore. The system makes it so easy for you to parallel park. As you can see here, you can clearly see the curve. That way you don't damage your wheels and your tires. So the system would have paid for itself by saving you from the damaged wheels and damaged tires. When you put your vehicle in reverse, the backup screen will come up and show you the rear of your vehicle. And if you hit the turn signal, the size, the left or the right hand side will turn on and show you how far you are away from the curve. You can also look at the small screen on the side and see the 360 degrees view. So here's the vehicle in reverse. As soon as you put it into gear, you can see that the front screen turns on. That way you can see what's in the front of the vehicle. Number 4, being able to see your blind spot is a big plus. When you're driving down the road and you're making a lane change, you wanna see what's in your blind spot. You can take a look at the small screen on the side, which shows you everything around the vehicle. Or when you hit the turn signal, the screen will actually pop up the left or the right camera. That way you can see where you're going. 5. When you're making a right turn or a left turn and you want to see the curve, let's just say you're in a small residential street and when you're trying to make that turn, you want to see the curve so that way you don't hit the curve or go over the curve with your rear wheels. Now you can do that. When you flip on the turn signal switch, it'll show you that screen and now you can see the curve where you are away from it. 6. The system will show you lane markers as well as parking lines. That way you can tell how center you are in the lane. 7. Let's just say you can't see out of your windshield. Your windshield is covered with mud, snow, ice, frost. you can use the camera, the front camera, to actually see where you're going without using your windshield. Recommend it, but it can help you out in sticky situations. Like, let's say someone drove over and splashed a whole bunch of mud onto your windshield and you can't see anything, your camera will actually help. It's not covered up with mud as well. Number 8, the system is very low power, which leads into number 9. You can leave your system on 24/7 to report, or you can choose to just have it turn on whenever you want and it will still record. And the system is really small. All the cameras are tiny, so you can actually hide it away out of sight, out of mind. That way people won't be able to tell that you have camera system or that they're being recorded. That way it'll add a little bit more stealthy to your vehicle when you're camping or sleeping in your van in an urban area. System will be live and recording, running, helping you know what's going on around your vehicle. 11, So now the camera is a low light system, so you don't need a lot of light for the camera to be able to see. You'll still be able to tell what's going on around your vehicle from little light to no light at all, but usually just the moonlight would actually let you see what's going on. Let's just say your eyes cannot see out, but the camera system will pick up movements and it'll show you a little bit of a figure. You won't be able to recognize the face or anything like that, but at least at nighttime you'll be able to see what's going on around that of not seeing or not knowing anything at all. And for this little money, $125, it's a steal. I'll leave the links in the descriptions below so you guys can check it out and try it out yourself. So leave me a comment if you have any questions or concern, or if you bought one and you tested it out and you confirmed that it works just as well as what I'm describing. Go ahead and comment below and let other people know how you feel about it, what you think about it, and yeah, just share it everyone so that way other people can have the safety and comfort that you're getting. Alright, so now I'm gonna kick into the video where I'm gonna show you how I connected my system and how I install it. So the first thing we're gonna be talking about is the main unit here. This is actually your main computer, the brain of the system. Over here on this side you have your LED lights indicator, and on the back of it you have your connection wires here and here. Here's your main unit. And here's the main wiring harness. Plug in this main port here, match up all the grooves, plug it in until you hear the click and you're done. This is where you plug in your USB sticks or USB flash drive, which supports up to 64 gigabytes, and that is for your DVR recordings. So this is where it's gonna store all the videos. And then over here you have your remote control sensor port. This is your remote control sensor. You need to have this visible, so install it somewhere where it will be able to read the remotes. Don't plug any of this in until you get all of your wirings from outside inside to your in-dash DVD area or wherever you're going to be placing the control unit. Next up, this is your AV output port. This is where you plug into your head unit. This wire over here, this is the wire that you need to connect into your reverse power source, so it's reverse signal. This is your main power supply wires. The black is always gonna be ground. This is your ground, it's connected to your ground. This yellow is a constant 12 volts port. So if you're connecting it to your house battery, you can connect this directly into your house batteries. That will give the power to the unit on always, all the time. And you do need to connect this into your power supplies to have it working. So if you're connecting it to your car, you need to connect this into a 12 volts power source, where this will be getting power either from your accessories or straight into your 12 volts battery. But if you plug this straight into your battery, it will run straight on without turning off. So I recommend if you're putting it into your vehicle, I would connect this into an accessory power source right in with this red wire. The red wire is your accessory port. This will actually turn the unit on or off. And if you connect these two together, be sure that it's gonna take a while for this unit to boot up and to load all of the programs and stuff like that. So if you're connecting it that way, it might take a little bit longer when it's booting up. I would say probably about 30 seconds to a minute. But if you plug it to a constant power on source, then it doesn't take that long. It turns on instantly. So I do have mine connected straight into my house battery. That way it's always on and it's always recording, and I can turn the remote on and off. I can use the remote to turn it on and off instantly without having to wait. All of your inputs from your camera. Here's the front camera port to plug into your wiring harness. This is the wiring harness. And if you can see, they have two distinctive connections. This one will go into your main unit, and the big one with the hole is gonna connect into your camera port. So all you have to do is line it up with the arrows. I don't know if you guys can see the arrows, but there's an arrow over here and over here. So you just line it up, plug it in, and you're set. So all you would have to do is mount your cameras wherever you want to mount it, and then plug in the wiring harness and run the wire straight inside to your main head unit. And the black one is going to be for the front camera. You would do the same, find the arrows, line them up, and plug them in. Alright, so if you guys can tell, there's a difference between these three cameras input and the front camera input. The front camera input doesn't have any signal wire because there's no signal for the front. Yellow is going to be your rear reverse camera, which has a signal wire. You can use this or you don't have to use it. You only use this when you have all of your connections, all of your reverse signal and turn signal connections inside behind your dash. Same thing with the left and the right. You have your turn signal over here, so if you have all of your wirings behind the dash, you can connect them here. That way you don't have to run them outside from your headlights. And of course I have the one for the rear camera plugged in. And here you can see, here's the signal wire from the reverse light. So if you want to connect it to your rear reverse light, all you have to do is use that cable and connect it, and it will give the power signal to the head unit. Now here's the right camera, which is the blue, and the same thing, it has a power wire that you can connect into your headlights. So if you don't have any connection behind your dash, then you can just use this wire and connect it into your headlight turn signal. And over here I have one of the cameras. This is the left hand side, which is the red. They do provide some gauntlets, some rubber gauntlets for you to put on to secure it to the hole that you drill, wherever you're gonna drill it, underneath your mirror, or if you have a place somewhere where you're gonna be drilling, make sure you drill the hole, plug this into the hole, and then push your camera in. That way it will be snug and tight and secure. Just make sure that all of your wirings are all complete before you actually push this in, because you do need to rotate this around and adjust your viewing angle. So don't push it all the way in until you connect all of your wires and have everything working. They do include two different gauntlets in here. One is flat and one is at a slight 12 degree angle. So depending on your mounting situations, you use the one that matches your mounting style. So now you have all of your inputs, all of your cameras, all the connections. They've included everything inside the kit to make it an easy install. So you guys just have to follow the instructions and we'll be done. So now that we have everything all figured out, all the wirings and stuff figured out, I'm gonna go outside and I'm gonna drill some holes and put the cameras in. Let me show you how I install my cameras. Okay, so you need a flathead. Go in and pry it open. So this is the camera. You need to put the wire in first. Let's get it through and then pull it out. And then next you will need to put your garment in first. And then with this, you just tape this into this part to hold them together. That way you can fish your wire to the engine bay. The wire, all you have to do is run it across. So we're gonna run the wire from over there all the way to over here, and we're gonna tuck it inside to where that radio antenna wire is, which is this orange wire. There's a rubber garment there that you can tuck the wires underneath, and it'll go straight into your interior cabin, which is your gloves compartment. And this is your right hand side. And you do the exact same thing over here. Mounting it using this right here, just do the exact same thing as the other side. And then the wire would run and go straight inside here. So that is mounted using two screws, one on each side. And this is where it's coming out from, right here. And then you just connect it into your main wire looms. Okay, so as you guys can see there, that's where I got all of my wires coming in from, using that antenna garment. Okay, so now we're inside. Here's the glove box. And I'm gonna get all the fish out of wires out from inside the glove box over here. Just have to take this off. And I have the left and right and front cameras coming in from the passenger side through that antenna port. Get all the wires to one side and then in. And then the reverse would go back in the back, coming in from the back of the van all the way up. That's the easiest way, and that's how I did it. I don't know if you guys want to do that or not. That's up to you, but that's how I did it. So there you go. And everything would come out up here into this wire looms, and you just plug this directly into your 360 degrees computer unit and it will work. Okay, so here's the main wire looms. I've plugged it in and all of the wires are in there, all nice and tight. That's your reverse camera right here. And all of your other wires are all tucked in behind there. So that's how I wired it. All the wires are inside here and runs down to the gloves compartment. So that's where I put the DVR. It's right down here inside the gloves compartment. That way it doesn't get too hot. So this is how you set it up. This is your main screen. All you have to do is hit the OK button, which will bring up your menu. And you will have to go down to words view. And then go down and select manual correct VIC, which is for a van or a truck or SUV. You need that big because it's a large vehicle, so that's why you need to go into the big menu. This is what you need, is the little checkerboard to actually set it up, but I don't have it and I didn't buy that, so I'm using my own. This is what I'm using here. You can see a toy box. I measured it out to the same distance. I'll leave a link in the description with the photos and the descriptions of how long or what you need to measure. You just follow that and set it up. So as you can see, you have your arrows right here. All you have to do is move this down to there. And it is quite slow. And what you need to do is move it to the outside corner up here. That's your first point. And then the next one is going to be over here on this point. And then the next one is down here on that point. And the next one is on that point. So just follow the instructions and you guys will be okay. I'm just doing my own because I don't have that mat. But you can choose to buy it or you can just do it like me. Once you have that little diagram, you can set it up pretty easily. So that was for the front. So you need to set it up on all four corners, the front, the two sizes, and also the rear. And then also in your bird's eye view, you have the correct palm, which you need to go in and set. So here you just measure your vehicle's length and width. And you just enter it in here. If you don't know the centimeters, just go into Google and convert it. But you do need to put in all of your perimeters here. And then as well as your front camera distance away from your rear. Or here is your left and right. How far are they away from your front camera? So you need to set all of that, just kind of go through the menu and read up on it. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask me down in the comments below. And then one more setting that you guys have to do is in here. You can also do a manual adjust if it doesn't line up. And what you need to do is go into a parking lot with lines. That way you can see the camera and all the lines, if they match up or not, and then you can manually adjust it. And in this menu here, if you go into your display and choose size setting, you could actually select your camera. So here's the front camera, and you can actually zoom in or zoom out however you like it. I usually just zoom out all the way so that way I can see everything. And then you could also move up or down, like right there. You can see it's moving up and down. So you can choose to move it up or down or left to right. But usually I just leave it alone because I center all of my cameras, so I don't have to mess around with that. And then in the control setting, you can go into your camera setting, which if you mounted your camera backwards, you can actually go in here and choose the camera mirror. So if you choose yes, it will rotate the camera to the correct positions if you mount it incorrectly or upside down. And then in this control setting, which is control and then control setting, here you can choose to have it display the turn signal lights. If you want it to when you turn on the turn signal and it's automatically turned on the screen, you can select that in here with the turn light, and you can select all kind of options. So you just have to go to the menu and just play with it. So I just leave this on all day, all night. I can turn it off whenever I want to, but because it's such a low power draw on my house battery bank that I'm not even worrying about it. It is 12 volts, so there's no converter or anything like that to suck off more electricity. Even in low light conditions, with just the headlights on, if I can't see anything in the front, I can always look at the screen and it'll show me a bunch of stuff that I'm actually missing on the road. just pull over into a dark street, and as you can see, there's no street lights in the back or in the front. There is a street light all the way up front, which is about 400 or 500 feet away, and the camera is working just fine. And here is the left hand side. As you can still make out the ground. So if someone is walking out there, you should be able to see them. Here, I'm just gonna stick out my hand. As you can see my hand down there waving. But pretty much, you can still make out what's going on outside of your van with all the blinds and stuff closed. But the rear, you can see what's going on. The front, you can definitely see. So here I am driving with no lights on. And as you can clearly see stuff. Front, back, sides, rear, and this is with no lights. This is the front, and here is your surround area. Here's your back cameras. Of course, I do have a street light right there, which is a pretty low light still. It's pretty dark over here. Can't really see anything. But with the camera being in the low light setting, you can actually see what's going on. Here's the side of the vehicle. Of course, this area here is the street light shining in. And then this area over here is blocked by the car next to me. So that's why it's kind of dark. Here's the door open. Of course, with the lights on. So if you turn on your side light, you could actually brighten it up and you can see quite well. But without that side light, it's gonna be really dark. There we go. That's with the lights off. And you can still manage to see a little bit. It's not very lit, but it's doable. And on this side, of course, there's no light at all. There's nothing blocking. You can see the concrete, you can see the floor just fine. So it does work quite well at nighttime. Alright, I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. If you found it helpful and you liked it, please go ahead and smash that like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, consider subscribing below. And until next time, Kenny out. Wait, just one more thing. See you guys on the next videos when I'm revealing how you can win the two systems that I've mentioned on the giveaways for the 1,000 subscriber. We're gonna try to figure it out, and we're gonna see how we're gonna give it away and still have some fun with it. Okay, that's it. That's all I have to say. Thank you guys. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.